Hello students, in this video let us discuss the applications of the electronic effects. Okay, in a previous videos we discussed that inductive effect, resonance, mesomeric effect and aromatic nature and finally hyperconjugation. Okay, so based on all these electronic effects we can explain the stability of the reaction intermediates like carbocation, free radical, carbanion. Okay. And then we will discuss about the acidic nature of alcohols, carboxylic acids, phenols and finally basic nature of amines. Okay, so let us start with the stability of the carbocation. Okay, stability of carbocation, stability of carbocation. So here already we discussed that stability order of the carbocations means the simple carbocation can be a hyperconjugation. So the cation which has a more number of alpha hydrogens means that it has a more number of hyperconjugative structures. So that is the most stable carbocation. So the tertiary carbocation is more stable. The simple example is CH3 plus CH3CH2 plus CH3CH CH3 plus and CH3C plus and then CH3 this one CH3. Okay, the simple carbocation ethyl primary, here isopropyl secondary, tertiary butyl, tertiary butyl of course tertiary carbocation. Now here in this case here three 9 alpha hydrogens that has a more number of hyperconjugate structures, here 6 alpha hydrogens, here 3 alpha hydrogens, here 0 alpha hydrogens. Actually here these are stabilized by the hyperconjugation. Okay, so in this case that's why it is a tertiary carbocation more stable. Okay, so already you know that hyperconjugation CH2 plus, for suppose this CH signal electrons are delocalized. Okay, delocalization of the CH sigma electrons into the vacant orbital. Okay, in a carbocation that is nothing but a hyperconjugation. So in this case here either CH sigma bonding electrons can be delocalized. Here possibility of 3 CH bonds, here possibility of the 9 CH bonds. So more hyperconjugate structures means more delocalization of the positive charge. Okay, that means that this positive charge can be delocalized onto the 3 oxygen atoms, here in this case 9, sorry, 3 hydrogen atoms, here in this case 9 hydrogen atoms. So here more stability, that is, okay. So more hyperconjugate structures, more stable. And next, see, yeah, CH3, CH plus, and CH3. Now CH3, CH2, your CH plus, and CH2, CH3. Okay. So between these two, of course, here additional I am adding one more carbocation, that is this one. So which carbocation most stable? And next here one more carbocation. Yeah, this one. Which carbocation is the most stable? Here in this case, here 3, 3, here 6 alpha hydrogens. It is stabilized by the 6 hyperconjugative structures. Here 3 and here 3 are 4 alpha hydrogens. Okay. Next here, these 2 hydrogens, 2 alpha hydrogens. Okay. But here, this hydrogen is not involved in a hyperconjugation. Because at the bridge head position, sp2 planarity not exist. sp2 carbon not possible on the bridge head position. Okay, this one not exist actually. Here sp2 carbon on the bridge head position not possible. Okay, now here this bridge head carbocation not exist, very unstable. Not exist, very unstable. Because that carbocation carbon must have the planar shape. Okay, sp2 and planar shape. But in this case here, the planarity is not possible at the bridge head position. Okay, so that's why in this case it is the least stable. Now here, see this one, 6 alpha hydrogens more stable, 4 alpha hydrogens, 2 alpha hydrogens, and this is the least stable carbocation. Bridge head carbocations are least stable, even it is less stable than the methyl carbocation. Because of course it is not exist. It is not exist, very unstable. Okay. So CH3 plus is somewhat more stable than the bridge head carbocation. So next you see this one. Yeah. CH2 double bond CH and CH2 plus. CH3 CH2 plus. Okay. And CH3 CH. Yeah, next year. I'm writing benzyl carbocation. Benzyl carbocation. Here, which one is the most stable carbocation? Okay. Which one is the most stable carbocation? See here in this case, additionally I am giving this one, CH2, CH plus, okay. So here in this case, among the electronic effects, the inductive effect, resonance and this is hyperconjugation, here resonance is a more influencing factor, okay. Resonance is a more influencing factor, that is a more stabilizing factor. Resonance is a more stabilizing factor. And next, hyperconjugation, okay, and inductive effect is a very less influencing, okay, it is a less influencing factor. The most influencing factor is the resonance, and between these two, hyperconjugation. So here, effectiveness of electronic effect, effectiveness of electronic factor. Resonance, okay, or mesomeric effect, then the hyperconjugation, and then inductive effect. Resonance and mesomeric effect are more influencing factors, and then next hyperconjugation and least inductive effect. Okay, now you see this one. Which carbocations are more stable? Here in this case, this carbocation stabilized by the delocalization of pi electron means resonance. This carbocation stabilized by the delocalization of the pi electron. We know that this one has a 5 resonating structure. This one has a 2 resonating structure. This one has 2 resonating structures. Okay. Now here, this one is stabilized by the hyperconjugation only. Now here in this case, not stabilized by the hyperconjugation. Not stabilized by the resonance. Okay. Already we discussed that. This positive charge is not delocalized. Okay. This positive charge is not delocalized. That is not in conjugation with this pi bond. So directly that positive charge is present on the double bonded carbon, then this positive charge is localized, not delocalized. But this positive charge is delocalized, here positive charge is delocalized. Here 5 resonance structure means more extent of resonance. Here more extent of the resonance. So here more extent of the delocalization for this positive charge, so more stable. So here this C compound more stable. Okay, C is more stable. Benzyl carbocation. This is a benzyl carbocation. Okay, and this one is allyl carbocation. Allyl carbocation. Here it is stabilized by the just 2 resonance factors. Okay, it is stabilized by the just 2 resonance factors. Very less extent of resonance. Here more extent of the resonance. So first here C and then A and B and then D. Okay, it is stabilized by the hyperconjugation. But the hyperconjugation is less influencing than the resonance. Okay, now between these two, here higher extent of resonance, more stable. Here less extent of resonance, less stable. And compare with this one. Here no resonance, no hyperconjugation. Okay, that's just positive charge is localized. So it is the least stable carbocation. Okay. Yeah. So let us discuss some more examples. Okay. Here, see this one. This is a positive charge. Positive, here pi bond. Here positive charge. Here positive charge. Now which is the most stable carbocation? Okay. So first of all here the carbocations which are stabilized by the resonance are more stable. Okay. So here in this case there is a resonance. Here there is a resonance. Here no resonance. So here A and C more stable. Between these two, it is a secondary carbocation, it is a tertiary carbocation. So tertiary carbocation more stable because here in this case so just 2 alpha hydrogens, 3 alpha hydrogens, 5 alpha hydrogens possible. Tertiary. Now it is secondary, here 2 alpha hydrogens only possible. That means here resonance plus hyperconjugation. Here resonance plus hyperconjugation. Okay, those are the more stable. But in this case here, along with the resonance, 5 alpha hydrogens, 5 hyperconjugate structures possible. For this one, along with the resonance, only 2 hyperconjugate structures possible. So here, carbocation A more stable than this C. And next, B and D, it is tertiary, it is a secondary. Here in this case, 2, here 3, 7 alpha hydrogens. Okay, 7 alpha hydrogens. Here in this case, here 2, 4 alpha hydrogens. So here in this case, B more stable than the D. Okay, I think here we can think like that. This one has 7 alpha hydrogens, this one has 5 alpha hydrogens. It should be more stable. But here this A and C are in, first of all stabilized by the resonance. Okay, but in this case there is no resonance. Here A and C are stabilized by the resonance as well as hyperconjugation. So here A and C are the more stable. Okay, there is more. And next, one more example. This is a benzyl carbocation. pH plus this one. Diphenyl methyl carbocation. Okay, triphenyl methyl carbocation. Okay, this is a triphenyl. Triphenyl methyl carbocation. Is also called as tritial carbocation. Also called as tritial carbocation. Okay. Now here, next one more structure. CH2, here CH2 plus. Which is the more stable one? See, in this case, it is stabilized by the resonance with 3 benzene rings. More extent of resonance. Here resonance is only 1 benzene ring. So here, carbocation C more stable, B and A, and least stable D. Because it is not stabilized by the resonance. Okay, it is not stabilized by the resonance. Okay, no conjugation. But first three are stabilized by the conjugation. Here conjugation is 3 phenyl ring. So more extent of the delocalization for the first feature. So it is a more stable carbocation. Okay. And next, 7th one. CH3, here CH2, here OCH3. Yeah, this benzyl carbocation. Benzyl carbocation and CH3. CH3 plus. Now which is most stable? Here all are stabilized by the resonance with the benzene ring. But here additionally 3 alpha hydrogens, here 6 alpha hydrogens. So additionally that is stabilized by the resonance. Okay, that's why this carbocation is more stable. Okay, and similarly, 8th one, CH2 develop on CH plus, and this is benzene ring. Okay, next CH2 develop on CH, and CH2 plus, next CH3 CH plus, this one, benzene ring, and next CH2 plus, this one. Okay, so which carbocation most stable here? You see, it is stabilized by the resonance with the benzene ring as well as 5-1. Here is stabilized by the resonance with the benzene ring and hyperconjugation. Here stabilized by the only resonance. Here stabilized by the resonance only. Okay? But here allyl benzyl, which is most stable, benzyl carbocation most stable. Then this one, these two are most stable. Okay? Because additionally hyperconjugation, additionally resonance. Here between hyperconjugation and resonance, resonance is a more influencing factor. So A more stable, next to C and D and B. That is stability on. Okay? Here resonance, again resonance with the 5-bond. Here resonance but hyperconjugation. Okay, resonance is a more influencing factor. And next, 7th one. This one, benzyl carbocation. CH3O. CH2 plus. This is the one carbocation. Now CH3O, CH2, CH2 plus. Now which is the more stable carbocation? Okay? Which one is the more stable carbocation? You can see here in this case, it is stabilized by the resonance with benzene ring. Now it is stabilized by the conjugation. That means plus some effect. Stabilized by the plus some effect. Okay? So carbocations which are stabilized by the plus sum effect are more stable. Okay. So in this case, you see, on this carbon there is no octet configuration. CH bonds 2 and the carbon oxygen bond 1, 6 electrons. But in this case, CH bonds 2 and the carbon oxygen bonds are the 2. So how many electrons around the carbon? There is an octet configuration. Around the oxygen, octet configuration. So it can be stabilized by the octet configuration. Okay. From the plus sum effect of the OCH3, it can get the octet configuration. So here, the B is more stable. B is more stable than the A. Okay, B is more stable than the A. Here in this delocalization, there is no octet configuration is provided for the carbon. But in this plus sum effect, in this conjugation, positive charge lone pair conjugation, that one structure getting a octet configuration. So more stable. It is more stabilized by the plus sum effect of the OCH3. Now here in this case, it is not in conjugation. It is not in conjugation. Okay. It is not in conjugation. Let's see here. I am adding one more cation. See this one. CH3, CH2 and CH2 plus. Okay. So here in this case, C more stable than the A. C is more stable than the A. Now here between these two, let's see. Here OCH3 plus M effect is not working. Then here only minus I effect is working. Minus I effect is working. Here also minus I effect is working. But plus M effect is dominating than the minus I effect. Okay? Here plus M effect is dominating than the minus effect of the oxygen. Here only minus effect is working because that is not in conjugation. Okay? So that's why here, due to that minus I nature of this oxygen, this carbon carries a slightly positive charge. So here positive repel each other. So its energy increases, so it is a least stable actually. Okay? Least stable. And here that D carbocation more stable. Why? Because here there is no minus I group, this methyl is a plus I group. And here two alpha hydrogens totally. Okay? That means here two hyperconjugate structures possible. Here also we can write the two hyperconjugate structures. But here due to minus effect of the oxygen, your positive charge is rising. So positive positive repel each other. So it gets unstability. But in this case, no minus I group. So when compared with this cation is more stable. Okay? D is more stable than the C. Okay? Yeah. Let's discuss some more examples. CH3, CH2 plus. CH3 oxygen CH2 plus and CH3 NH CH2 plus and CH3 S CH2 plus. Okay, so here in this case, which carbocations are more stable? Here, all these cations are stabilized by the plus sum effect. Okay, all these cations are stabilized by the plus sum effect. Now here, writing the structure for this one. CH3, yes, double bond CH2 plus, okay, that is stabilized by the plus sum effect. Now here, this one also stabilized by the plus sum effect, NH double bond CH2 plus, it is stabilized by the plus sum effect. Now here, no plus sum effect, so it is the least stable carbocation, okay, A is the least stable carbocation. Now which is the most stable carbocation? That means that depends on the strength of the electron donating nature, strength of the plus sum group. Your oxygen, nitrogen and sulfur, which is a strong plus sum group. Nitrogen is a strong plus sum group. Okay? So you see more stable than D. And here, D actually. In this case here, the sulfur acting as a weak plus sum group when compared with the nitrogen and the oxygen. Because by donating of this lone pair of electrons, this pi bond is a 3p and 2p. Okay, that pi bond is formed between 3p orbital of the sulfur and 2p orbital of the carbon. But in this case here, this pi bond is formed between 2p orbital of the nitrogen and 2p orbital of the carbon. That means here the pi bond between two similar orbitals is stronger than the pi bond between two different orbitals. Because in this case here, these are smaller in size, there is a more extent of overlapping. These are smaller in size. And same size. But here 3p means here is a larger in size and 2p is a smaller in size. So there is no extent of overlapping. There is no much extent of overlapping area So this pipe valve, this lateral valve overlapping is very weaker. That's why the plectrum effect is less than the nitrogen and oxygen. Okay? So sulfur plectrum effect very less. Already we discussed at the mesomeric effect. Okay? That's it. And next, one more thing. Here the point is carbocations, okay, carbocations are destabilized. Carbocations are destabilized by minus I groups. For suppose CF3 and CH2+, and Cl3 CH2+, and CH3 CH2+. And in this case, minus I group. The CF3 also minus I group. But methyl is a donating group. So carbocations are stabilized by the donating group. Of course, here hyperconjugation is also possible. So in this case, this is the most stable. Next, CCl3, CF3. CCl3 is a weak minus I group. CCl3 is a weak minus I group. Here, CF3, all these three more electronegative fluorine atoms create the more positive charge on this carbon. So more repulsion. That's why it is a more destabilized. It is a more destabilized. Okay? That's it. Here CCl3, here chlorine can increase the less magnitude of the positive charge. Okay? Because here chlorines are the weak minus I groups, less electronic. That's it. Now here, the point is, see this. Fluorine, plus charge, Cl, the Cl, plus charge, and Cl. Now which is the most stable carbocation? Which is most stable carbocation? Here in this case, plectrum effect is working because directly attached. Plectrum effect is working. So in this case, this is the most stable. Of course, here fluorine is a strong minus I group. But here, than the minus I effect is the plectrum effect is slightly working. Here, the fluorine strong plectrum effect than the chlorine because here fluorine 2p orbital, fluorine 3p orbital. Same reason like this. Here, the pi bond between the 3p orbital of the chlorine and the carbon 2p orbital is a weaker. So, the plectrum effect of the chlorine very less. Okay? But if fluorine 2p orbital, carbon 2p orbital, so that pi bond is stronger after delocalization of the lone pair of electrons. So that fluorine is slightly acting as a strong plectrum group than the chlorine. Okay, that's it. Yeah, next one more, 11th one. Here aromatic carbocations are more stable. Aromatic carbocations are more stable. Here this is a tropelium cation. This one is a tropelium cation. Okay, and next see this one. Here phosphate. Which is most stable here? B is most stable. 2π, 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 6 paracons are aromatic. That 2π, 2π, 4 paracons are anti-aromatic. That is the least stable. Now between these two, it is stabilized by the conjugation with 2π bond. It is stabilized by the conjugation with only 1π bond. So here D and C. That's it. Aromatic cations are more stable and anti-aromatic cations are least stable. Anti-aromatic cations are least stable. Okay? And here, the different one is triphenyl carbocation and aromatic cation. Aromatic cation. Which is most stable? Aromatic cation is most stable. Okay? Aromatic cation is most stable. Here, even conjugation with three benzene rings, but this one has aromatic nature, so it is stabilized by the aromatic character. So, tropelium cation is more stable even than the triphenyl methyl carbo cation. Okay? And next, the one more simple one, 13th order. You see here in this case. Here oxygen is here positive charge. Here positive charge. Here oxygen. Positive charge. Okay. Now here it is stabilized by the plectrum effect. Stabilized by the plectrum effect. Okay. here no plus-M effect. Only minus effect is working. Only minus I effect is working. Yeah, due to minus effect, this carbon, this oxygen directly increase the more magnitude of the positive charge on this carbon. So here positive repel each other. Now here, this oxygen is far away from the positively charged carbon. Induced effect is a distance dependent. So that minus I effect of the oxygen is less in this case. That increase positive charge on this carbon, increase very less positive charge on the second carbon. So less positive charge and here positive charge, less repulsion. Here positive charge, here more positive charge, more repulsion. Here in this case, no minus I effect. So it is not destabilized by the minus effect. These two are destabilized by the minus effect. Here this is stabilized by the plus one effect of the oxygen. So here, the first one is more stable. And next, fourth one. And the third, and the two. It is more destabilized by the minus I effect. That is nearer to the carbocation. Okay? Yeah. So next, some more examples. See this. Cations are stabilized by the plus one effect. Cations are stabilized by the plus one effect. CH2 plus, this one is a CH3, hyperconjugation. This one CH2 plus, here OCH3. CH2 plus, and this is an O2. So in this case, first of all, it is a plus one group, it is a plus H group, it is a minus M as well as minus A, of course. Okay? Minus M, minus A. Yeah. So in this case, which carbocation is most stable? Yeah, the plus one effect, donating groups increase the stability of the carbocation. It is stabilized by the plus one effect, it is stabilized by the hyperconjugation. From the methyl hyperconjugation, from the OCH3, plus one effect. So here, C more stable. C more stable. You see in this case, OCH3 donating group, that is simple, OCH3 donating group. So this donating group increase the magnitude of the negative charge at the ortho position and para position. OCH3 donating group increase the negative charge at ortho para. Whenever there is a negative charge increased at the para position, this is more attraction, the positive negative, more stabilization. Okay? Here I am writing the resonant structure. CH2. Here OCH3. This one plus. Okay? Next pair comes moving to this one. Next pair comes moving to this one. So here, negative positive, 5-1. So like this here, this positive charge is dispersed by the donating nature of the OCH3. Okay? This positive charge is dispersed by the donating nature of OCH3. Okay? That's it. Now here, CH3 is also donating group. But it is a weak donating group than the plus one group. Hyperconjugation effect is less than the mesomeric effect or resonance effect. So that's why here compound C more stable next and B. Okay, CH3 donating, OCH3 donating. But OCH3 is a strong donating that can increase the more magnitude of the negative charge, here more positive charge, so more stabilization. First to negative adjacent, more stabilization. So C. And here A and D, A more stable than the D. Because NO2 is a withdrawing group. This withdrawing group increase the positive charge at ortho and para. So here positive, repel each other. That's why D is destabilized. Okay? So the finally, the carbocations are stabilized by the plus M group and destabilized by the minus M group. Okay? That means carbocations are stabilized by the electron donating group and destabilized by the electron withdrawing group. Okay? Carbocations are stabilized by electron donating groups and destabilized by electron withdrawing groups. okay? Destabilizes by electron withdrawal. That's it. Yeah. Next here, see this one. CH2 plus, here CH3 only. The CH3 at a different position, sir. CH2 plus CH3. This one CH3. Okay, and simple carbocation. Now here only one group of plus H, here plus I. Here only plus I effect is working. Here plus H, plus I. Already we discussed that at the metaposition, no hyperconjugation, no resonance effect. Okay? How we can say in this case, you see, the CH3 donating group, the CH3 donating group, plus H group, so increase the negative charge at ortho position and para position. So here negative positive adjacent each other, more stabilization. The CH3 of the donating group increase the negative charge at ortho position and the para position. Okay? So again here positive negative more stabilization. But here in this case, addition. Here additionally there is a strong plus I group because very nearer to this CH2 plus. So A more stable than this C. Because plus I effect is less. Now here coming to the metaposition. Okay. Of course here at the metaposition plus I effect is more than the para position. But this CH3 plus I effect is not working with CH2 plus. Because this CH3 increases the negative charge at this ortho position and para position. Okay, the CH3 donating group increase the negative charge at ortho position and para position, but not at the meta position. So here, there is CH2 plus, here there is no negative charge. That means here, there is no stabilization from the CH3 donating nature. But in this case, CH3 ortho position increase the negative charge, adjacent positive charge, so more stabilization. CH3 at the para position, negative charge at ortho position and at the para position. So here more stabilization. Okay, positive to negative adjust to each other. Okay? That's it. Of course, here we can write the resonance structure like this. Okay, CH2. Pi bond, double bond, yes, CH plus hydrogen, hydrogen. Hyperconjugation. Okay? And then here, it is only stabilized by the plus I effect, B, and least stability. Okay, least stability. Now here, first suppose, next, 16th order, CH2 plus, okay, now I am changing the different group, OCH3, and next, CH2 plus 5 bond, OCH3, OCH3, now here OCH3 is a plus one group, plus M group and minus. Here only minus sign. Here plus M and minus. This plus M group increases the negative charge at ortho position, para position. So more stability. At ortho position, para position. Here ortho position, para position. That means here at this carbon there is no negative charge raising. So it is not stabilized by the OCH3 plus M nature. So these two are stabilized by the OCH3 plus M nature. Now which is more stable? This is a plus M effect at ortho position, para position, same. Okay, equal. So it is stabilized by the plus M effect, it is stabilized by the plus M effect equally with the same extent. Now here, but it is a minus I group. So because of this minus effect, it is more, it is a less stable than this one. Because OCH3 is far away, here minus I effect is very less. So fourth one more stable next to and one and three. Why three is the least stable? Because only induced effect is working. If OCH3 plus one effect is working, is not working with this positively charged carbon. Only inductive effect is working. So because of this only inductive effect, here these are destabilized. Okay? So that increases magnitude of the positive charge. So here positive positive repel each other. So that's a less stable carbon. Okay? First suppose, CH2 plus pi bond. CH2 plus plus, here NO2, 2 plus NO2, all these are destabilized because NO2 is electron withdrawing group only. At any position, electron withdrawing group. Your minus M minus. You are only minus I. Your minus M minus I. Okay? Here in this case, one is more stable. You are more destabilized by the minus M effect. It is more destabilized by the minus M effect. So three more stable. Next, between these two, your more minus I effect. Very near to the CH2 plus. You are far away to the CH2 plus. So fourth one and second. Okay? So carbocations are stabilized by the plus M groups and destabilized by the minus M groups. Okay. Okay. So next here, see this. Here only alkyl groups. Huh? Yeah, there are three hydrogens. Here only two hydrogens. Here only one hydrogen. That means here hyperconjugation possibility with one CH bond, hyperconjugation possibility with two CH bonds. Here hyperconjugation possibility with three CH bonds. So it is the most stabilized by the hyperconjugation. So B most stable, C, D, and E and A. Here no hyperconjugation, but here plus psi effect. But these three are stabilized by the hyperconjugation. Here more extent of hyperconjugation because three CH bonds can be involved in a delocalization. Okay. Now we are coming to this one. At metaposition, no hyperconjugation effect is working. That means, of course, this is acting hyperconjugation possible by the hyperconjugation negative charge increasing at ortho positions or para positions. Okay, na? But not at this meta position. That means here this positive charge is not influenced by the CH3 plus M effect. Sorry, plus H effect. Okay, na? But whenever at the para position, that positive charge is influenced by the plus H effect of the methyl because that is. Create the negative charge exactly at that attached carbon. That's why generally we are saying that at metaposition no plus M effect or no plus H effect. So only consider plus I effect. Tertiary butyl and methyl, which is strong plus I group. Tertiary butyl strong plus I group, so more stable. And here no plus I group, so it is the most stable. Now coming to this one. The CH3 plus H effect, CD3 plus H effect. Here CH and CD electrons are involved in a delocalization. Okay, here CH electrons are involved in a delocalization. CH bond is a weaker bond, but CD bond is a stronger bond. So, the delocalization of CH sigma electrons is more extent than the delocalization of CD sigma electrons because it is a stronger bond. It is a stronger bond. So, delocalization of the CD sigma electrons is very less when compared with the CH sigma electron. So hyperconjugation is effect higher for the CH bond bonding sigma electron than the CD sigma bonding electron. So it is the most stabilized. Okay. So second one is more stabilized than the three. That's it. So first these two are stabilized by the hyperconjugation. And here hyperconjugation effect is more, here hyperconjugation effect is less. Now coming to this one. OCS3 at metaposition only minus I effect. Your CH3 at metaposition, of course, plus I effect. So it is stabilized by the plus I effect. Fifth one. And it is stabilized by the minus effect. Here no minus I, no plus I groups. So here 1 and 4. The stability out of the carbocation.